Hi, and welcome to the second part of the session on extending Copilot for Sales. My name is Amreek Singh. I'm a Senior Solution Architect with the Fast Track team for Dynamics. A quick recap. In the part one, we covered the introduction, different extension points and the requirements, ELM process, and we ended that with a live demo on how to create your first plugin. If you haven't watched the part one, please do that before this part. In this part, we have some live demos. We will start with how to delete a custom plugin. Then we have a real-world scenario, but with a twist. We will be using Power Automate Flow instead of using an API. And we will end this session with some useful resources. How would you delete a plugin or an action? You may have multiple reasons why you want to do it. Maybe it's not relevant anymore, or it's not working as expected. Whatever the reason is, you can't delete a custom plugin in the Copilot Studio. The only way to achieve this is through Power Apps Maker's experience. And the third condition is the plugin must be published. So if your plugin is in a draft state, you may want to go back to the Copilot Studio and publish it before you can delete it. On the screen, this is my solution, Copilot for Sales extension. It has four items in there. The first one is a cloud flow. You can ignore this one because this is not relevant for this specific plugin. But the rest of the items are, you would see an AI plugin operation. You may have a multiple operations. Then you will have an AI plugin itself. Then you have a reference to your custom connector. If you try to delete the plugin, it will fail because of dependencies. So the very first thing you need to do is you select the plugin and look at the dependencies. Click on Use By. Here, you need to remove the first dependency here. And the AI operation, you can delete it here or you can delete it from the outside. And now you will be able to delete this plugin. So do not remove it from the solution, just delete it. Because if you remove it from the solution, it will still exist in a default solution. Let's look at a bit more realistic scenario. I have a banking customer who is using Copilot for Sales, and they would like to see the bank accounts and the balances displayed in the account summary when they interact with the Copilot in the Outlook experience. Here again, I will be using Enrich CRM Record Summary as extension point. Coming to the solution components, so there are a couple of things which we can't change, so we have to create a custom connector. But here, instead of using an API as a backend, I will be using Power Automate Flow. But there is a catch. That flow will be sitting behind the API manager. So this is my sample flow. It's not a production ready. So I'm using a HTTP request trigger here. And this is a URL I'll be using to trigger this flow. I'm using three different variables. The first one is status. I'm using this to capture the status of the flow. Right now, I initialize that to 404. This is to capture my response I want to send out. Right now, I'm saying not found based on my status. Then this entity type, I'm using this variable to capture the query string. So if you look at here, I'm using expression trigger output queries record type. So this record type is passed by Copilot to the custom connector, and the custom connector is passing to my Power Automate flow here. If you're worried about the number of actions, you don't need to do that, or you don't need to use this variable. You can pass that the expression straight in your condition. So here I'm checking if the entity type is equal to account, then do something. Otherwise, don't do anything. So here I'm calling my data source, and I'm passing the account ID here to get my accounts and the balances. In the next step, I'm just selecting the fields I really need. And then in the update message, I'm creating a message that I need to pass back to the Copilot. So here are all the values I'm reading from the data source. This is still hard-coded, so I'm just passing two records back to the Copilot. In reality, based on the number of records you're going to get from the data source, you could have gone through the loop and composed your message. As I mentioned before, it's not a production ready, it's just a sample. The other thing you could have done is use if condition. If the record count is greater than zero, then do all those kind of things. Otherwise, just, you know, send the 404 message R to the Copilot. Now at the end, you update the status to 200. And the last step is you're passing the status and the message. That's it. It's pretty simple. I have already tested this flow multiple times. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you in the flow history what information I'm getting back from the flow and what I'm passing back. So here I added a compose action. I already deleted that. I just wanted to show you all the parameters I'm getting from the Copilot. So if you look at the queries, record type, record ID, start date, time, top, skip, CRM type, URL. This is that information, but the Copilot for sales is passing to me. Now I'm going to look at what I'm passing back to the Copilot. So if you look at the information is exactly the same what we have in our sample in a public documentation. But right now, I'm not passing a contract information. What I'm passing is the account number, account name, and the balance. Let's have a quick look how to expose your Power Automate flow behind the APIM or API manager. So this is my APIM, and this is my existing API that I used in my last example. So the only thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to clone this one. So my second API is a clone of my first one. The only changes I have made is the backend here. So here I replaced my existing API URL with my flow URL. The important part here is I just put the URL up to parts. Now click on the action. And this is one of the most important part. You need to add a policy rewrite URI. So here, if you see it, I added the path / invoke and all the other query parameters, what my flow is expecting. So that's it. That's the only thing you need to change. So you made those two changes. And now your flow is available through the APIM. Now let's look at the custom connectors. In the last example, I used a sales extension. So what I did here is I created a copy of the sales extension and give it a name called Sales Copilot Extension with Flow. The host is exactly the same. If you look at the definition, I'm not changing anything. The only change is just I added a word clone in the path. I did that through a Swagger editor, go to paths, add the word clone in there, save your changes, and you're good to go. So let's create a plugin now. So here in a Copilot Studio, click on add action. And here you select your custom connector. Sorry, the name of the connector is Sales Copilot. Yes, Sales Copilot extension with Flow. Select a solution. Press next. So I'm not changing anything in the plugin. So that's the only available action. Press next. I don't need to change anything because I have all the required descriptions in my connector. Press next again. Now select a connection or create a connection. Test action. That's it. Now test this in Outlook. If you remember, in our Power Automate flow, we had a condition: if entity type is equal to account, then process the account information. So if you go to the opportunity summary or opportunity info, you won't see any insights from our custom plugin. But if you move to the account now, now you can see the information or insights from Sales Copilot extension with Flow. You have two different accounts there. The first one is a NetSaver account. If you click on the citation, you can see the account number, account name, and the balance. And the second account is a savings account. This is how easy it is to enhance the record summary from the third-party systems. So here are a couple of really useful resources. The first one is aka.ms Copilot for Sales Extensibility. You will find all the information related to the extensibility here. You can find all the extension points, the input and output parameters, descriptions, sample response, and also the sample custom connector. The second link is, if you want to have a preview support from the product team, go there and register. It's aka.ms Copilot for Sales Extensibility Preview. Thanks for listening. I hope it was helpful.